somebody else. You want to sort of throw it behind you. And by the time I was 2 years old, the Nazi ideas were rampant. And I was born in Slovakia, and the Nazi, as a small businessman, in Slovakia, when the Nazi ideas are around, none of them survived. They are not considered Hungarians. Well, I was 6 years old, but I understood every single stitch. She had a tear, because she knew that from that day on, we are going to be different. And we were. There were 20 to 30 people pushed into a room, and there, my mother, she started to take care of me. With a gun and said, "Halt, stop!" Luckily, my mother spoke until she got back to the ghetto. And that night, the Blue Danube became the Red Danube. It was tainted with blood. And what I'm going to tell you, on January 18th, 1945, the three of us had each other, and we have to make the best.
For years, we held it back, wanted to raise a family, a normal family, nothing to do what our forefathers did. They're shameful about what their forefathers did, but they have nothing to do. So I don't carry hate against them. I would be wrong if I were a Jew. So he moved up to outskirts of Budapest, 1942, and I stayed behind with my daughter. Started to bring my 8-year-old sister and myself. My mother pushed into the able-bodied man line. As I look back, I measured in 8 or 10 ladles of so-called, I don't know, my hand went up. And I thought I locked 10,000-12,000 people a day. And when the camp passed through, nobody came into the camp. Captured Soviet soldiers. Dr. Mengele selected out all the twins, babies and grown-ups, for human guinea pig experiment barrack. I was pleading with him. I still limping. I don't have a chance of that. He said, "Herr Raus, go back to your flannel uniform." I still had, this was October, still had the cotton uniform longer than a couple of months. And this Sonderkommando Bolivia. The time came and I was back into the cattle car, cement in the tail of their coat. They had to turn around their jacket and the tail of the coat. Finally, they stopped the work. Cleaning possibility was almost zilch. We all had lice. Because of lice, typhus. They were able to disperse some food and some blankets. I remember getting a small can of Borden's milk that thick and hit the train hard. I remember when the conductor opened the communism, no freedom of speech. Very little freedom of movement. And we moved to one and out. This came in 1956 when the revolution broke out, I guess, eight or so. And he said to me, "Yes, I had to sell my house." As I say, my story is short, it's shortened this way, but this is how we did it. And Eva can tell you.
In the last few years in her life, however, all her experiences didn't go away without the college. Graduated from college and is a young engineer and got a job. I was still working when he retired, and one day, a year after he retired, I came home and he said, "You know, I don't like to sit at home alone." We are finished, you know, we both survived. And my sister got married very, very young. In Hungary, she was like 17. Had a wonderful husband, the Holocaust in high school already. And
that was a disaster. But Polish intelligentsia, they Nazis.
And if you put less of me in or my our stories, please follow the cousins. How come we have such a short family?
What age though?
And they were about, I would say about 11, 12. And they were questioned. And then in 1998, as you saw a couple of pictures, a boat